54 casualties, 5 weeks since the coup in Myanmar, and protests continue to rock the country. Tear gas, flashbangs, stun grenades, security forces have been intensifying their crackdown using lethal force as the innocent civilians bear the brunt. Myanmar has urged India to return the police officers who crossed the border to evade taking orders from the military junta in Myanmar. Around 30 police officers and their families have fled Myanmar, according to reports, and sought refuge in India in the last 1 month. As the Myanmar military's brutal crackdown on dissent continues, a senior official from India's Mizoram state has said that she has received a letter from her counterpart in Myanmar requesting the return of these officers. The letter read, and I'm quoting now, "In order to uphold friendly relations between the two neighboring countries, you are kindly requested to detain 8 Myanmar police personnel who had arrived in Indian territories and hand over to Myanmar." On Thursday, the Indian police reported that 3 policemen have crossed the border, but the Myanmar authorities' letter mentions 8 officers. Indian state police officials say they are awaiting further instructions from the Home Ministry. The Indian Home Ministry has not responded to the request, but on Friday, the Indian External Affairs Ministry had said that they were still ascertaining the facts.
Myanmar ke ghatnakram pe हम बारीकी से नज़र बनाए हुए हैं, और जैसा कि मैंने पहले बताया था कि हम अपने सहयोगियों से, पार्टनर कंट्रीज से इस बारे में चर्चा करते रहें, और इन बातचीत में हमने कहा है कि इस मुद्दे को शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से मतभेदों को सुलझाना चाहिए, और ये हमारा पक्ष रहा है कि ये वहाँ जो भी स्थिति है वहाँ पे इसको शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से वहाँ जो मतभेद हैं उनको सुलझना चाहिए।
The military grabbed power on the 1st of February and arrested elected leader Aung San Suu Kyi. Joining us on the broadcast this minute is Ambassador G. Parthasarathy, former Indian ambassador to Myanmar. Good evening, Ambassador. Thanks very much for sharing your time and your perspectives. What is your assessment of the situation as of now, of the request that has been made by Myanmar, and how India should be responding?
Well, getting refugees from Myanmar when there is a shift from civilian rule to military rule and military rule back, we've had this refugee problem with Myanmar since, I would say, the last 25 years. In fact, the last batch which came when the earlier coup took place, even the former prime minister's daughter was with us. The policy is quite clear. It is has two directions. One, we consider it. Nobody is forced to return. The UN High Commissioner for Refugees is informed. And then we discuss it with the Myanmar government. So in this particular case, we'll also, Myanmar is a member of ASEAN. We will consult ASEAN because this is a problem which all Myanmar's neighbors, and particularly ASEAN, will be affected by. And in any case, major policy decisions of this nature we take only in consultation with the regional organization, which is ASEAN.
Right. And speaking of the coup in Myanmar, and the violence that we have been talking about, the clampdown has only intensified on part of the military junta. This is in spite of the pressure that's building on part of the international community. Now, speaking of which, India has made its stance clear. We just listened in to what the Ministry of External Affairs spokesperson also had to say in supporting democracy in Myanmar. What do you make of the steps that have been taken overall by regional powers so far to try and resolve the crisis in Myanmar?
Look, my experience of dealing with this country in one way or another over 20 years is that if you try to push them to a corner and behave high and mighty, they'll ignore you and do what they want with the Chinese. And don't forget, most insurgent groups in the Northeast normally cross the border into Myanmar and then enter China, the Yunnan province, where they're greatly welcomed. So we do cooperate with these matters, both with regard to what they need and what we need. In this particular case, it is a larger issue. It's an issue which we will consult ASEAN. But I want to tell you one thing. Pushing Myanmar to a corner or lecturing them as the West is doing doesn't matter an inch to them. They stood for this against this for the last 20 years, and the West did nothing about it. While Myanmar went into the arms of China, and then the West starts screaming they're too close to China. I think we deal with them in a more mature manner. We consult them. And I recall that the last time things moved was when President Kalam met President Than Shwe in Myanmar and quietly told him that, look, as a friendly country, we're telling you, you've been a long time in power, that people should have a say in government because that's international practice. We didn't make that public, and they listened to us. So as far as India is concerned, we tell them quite frankly in private what we feel, but we don't try to ostracize them. It is counterproductive, and I don't want them to walk further into the arms of China.
Ambassador Parthasarathy, thanks very much once again for joining us here on We On World Is One. Now, despite overnight raids by the security forces in Yangon, tens of thousands of people came out on the streets of Myanmar on Sunday to demonstrate against the coup. Into the early hours, soldiers and police moved into several districts of Yangon firing shots. According to the residents, police arrested at least three in Kaktoda township. The reason for the arrest is not known. A Myanmar soldier pointed a gun at a resident after the person was caught filming an arrest of a National League for Democracy Party member. Bracing for more protests, demonstrators in Yangon were seen using unusual ways to buy time in order to get away from the soldiers. In Yangon, protesters were seen practicing shield formations in preparation for clashes with the police. The anti-coup protesters practiced retreating and advancing with the makeshift shields. Not just this, protesters have also tried using long-standing superstitions to stop the police from charging at them, like the idea that it is bad luck to walk under traditional clothing. A nun who knelt in front of riot police during protests has said that she was prepared to lay down her life to protect others. In an interview, she has accused the security forces of beating and killing protesters. Since the coup started, security forces have been opening fire with stun grenades, rubber bullets, and live rounds. According to the United Nations, more than 50 protesters have been killed. Over 1,700 people have been detained. This excludes figures for the overnight detentions. Daily demonstrations and strikes have choked businesses and paralyzed the administration. The killings have drawn anger in the West and have been condemned by most democracies in Asia. The United States and some other Western countries have imposed limited sanctions on the military junta there. China, meanwhile, has said the priority should be stability and that other countries should not interfere. We are now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.